Cuomo's court. We have the perfect counselors. CNN legal and national security analyst Asha Rangappa and Harvard Law School professor emeritus Alan Dershowitz, author of The Case Against Impeaching Trump. Thanks to both of you. For the prosecution, Rangappa, why is this wrong?
Well, this is wrong on so many levels. So first, there is a law that prohibits the possession of undetectable firearms, so these plastic firearms. So as you noted, Chris, in your earlier discussion, by definition, anyone who is downloading these instructions and actually making these guns is going to be an illegal gun owner of said gun. The First Amendment argument, I don't think, really goes anywhere. There are public safety exceptions. In 1997, after the Timothy McVeigh bombing, Senator Feinstein passed an amendment making it illegal to post bomb-making instructions. So there are public safety exceptions to this. But I think really the practical effect is every day when you get on an airplane, you now have to worry about someone who may be sneaking in a plastic gun. And this is really just asking for potentially another 9/11. And I think that should be concerning to all of us.
Alan, the man who was just on argues, no, it's about speech. You should have the right to these ideas. These words are speech. These prints are speech. These designs are speech, and they should be protected.
Well, this is a terrible form of speech. These blueprints are awful, and I want to totally disassociate myself from what your previous guest one earlier said about this is good speech. It's terrible speech, but the question is it terrible speech that's protected by the First Amendment? And the answer is clear. We don't know. We don't know. We've never had a case like this go to the Supreme Court. The earlier case called the Progressive case, where they wanted to print instructions for how to make a hydrogen bomb, ended up being moot, and being moot for the reason that will probably make this case moot. By the time the case came to the court, the instructions were all over the place. Anybody could easily find how to make a hydrogen bomb.
How about the argument that they haven't seen it used in a crime?
Well, you know, that's not a good enough argument. Look, the answer is that the court may very well say the instructions, the blueprints are protected by the First Amendment, but you should disable any machine from making this kind of weapon, not only prohibit the weapon, which we've already done, but also prohibit any 3D machine from being capable of making the weapon. That would raise a Second Amendment question.
Yeah.
But Second Amendment issues are easier than First Amendment issues. So in the end, I think the blueprints will be allowed to be shown. And that's a moot issue because they've already been shown. And anybody who wants to have access to this is going to be able to get it one way or another.
And you have all the terrorist handbook stuff that's out there that falls into those same kind of categories.
They're already out there.
And
so I don't want to compromise
else.
The First Amendment.
And Chris, can I
go ahead, Asha.
Can I add one thing here? You know, right now, federal law protects gun manufacturers from tort liability, from being sued by people who get shot by the weapons they make.
These people who are putting these
instructions on are now, there are reasonably foreseeable consequences to what they are doing. And I think that if any of these guns end up being used in a crime, they can expect to have their pants sued off of them, and they should.
Well, we will see. That's an actually really interesting point. You know, there was a strain of First Amendment thought. We got to go. We got to leave it there. But, you know, I was doing some research on this, and there was some jurisprudence early on in discussion of the First Amendment that, you know, the First Amendment's purpose isn't just to justify the most ugly and vile things that can be said, that's not the standard always for enforcing the First Amendment. It'll be interesting to see if a judge takes that on at all, but we'll see. Alan Dershowitz, Asha Rangappa, thank you very much. Don Lemon standing by with a preview of CNN tonight, just minutes away. Boy, you know, this case really does strike at what can be so frustrating about the